आई एम मिस्टर सर्वज्ञ गांधी, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग फ्रॉम वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, सोलापुर. इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी रिगार्डिंग स्टेप्स टू कंस्ट्रक्ट रूट लोकस एंड प्लॉट द रूट लोकस यूजिंग मैटलैब. एट द एंड ऑफ द सेशन स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू अप्लाई द रूल्स टू कंस्ट्रक्ट रूट लोकस एंड सॉल्व द रूट लोकस प्रॉब्लम्स एंड एनालाइज द नेचर ऑफ रूट लोकस. So we have step number 5, where we are going to find breakaway point. So for finding breakaway point, step 1 is to have the characteristic equation, that is 1 plus g of s into h of s. So in this case we have 1 plus k divided by s into s plus 5 into s plus 10. So if we try to simplify, we have 1 plus k into s square plus 5s into s plus 10. Right? So if we further try to simplify, we will get 1 plus k divided by s cube plus 15s square plus 50s. Correct? So we have characteristic equation as s cube plus 15s square plus 50s plus k equal to 0. So then we have step number 2, where we are going to take the terms with k on one side. So we are going to have k as minus s cube minus 15s square minus 50s. So in step number 3, we are going to have dk by ds. So it will be minus 3s square minus 30s minus 50, and you are going to equate it to 0. So you have 3s square plus 30s plus 50 equal to 0. So if you try to find the roots of this, you are going to have s1 as minus 2.113 and s2 as minus 7.88. Out of this, which one is to be selected, minus 2.11 or minus 7.88? So you need to see these points on the root locus that you have drawn in step number 2. If you see that minus 2.11 is going to lie somewhere over here, so it is a part of root locus. So from that we can say that minus 2.11 is a valid breakaway point, and 7.8 lies somewhere over here. So it is not a part of root locus, so that point is invalid. Other method to check whether this point is valid or invalid is to put the value of s as minus 2.11 in this step number 2, where we have k. So if we are going to get the value of k as positive, it implies that is valid breakaway point. If we are getting the k value as negative, that implies that it is invalid breakaway point. So if we put the value of s as minus 2.11 in this equation, you are going to get positive value of k, and it will be 48.112, and that implies that it is a valid breakaway point. This is invalid. Fine. Then we have step number 6, where you are going to have intersection with imaginary axis. So for that we require the characteristic equation that we have already found, that is s cube plus 15s square plus 50s plus k equal to 0. So from that you are supposed to construct routes array. The highest power is 3, then s raised to 2, then we have 1, 15, 50 and k. So for s raised to 1, you are going to have 750 minus k divided by 15, and for s raised to 0, you are going to have k. Then you are going to select the element which has the k involved in it. So that is 750 minus k divided by 15, and you are equating it to 0. So you are going to get k marginal value as 750. Since k marginal value is positive, so that implies that it is going to have intersection correct? It is going to have intersection, and for that you need to consider the auxiliary equation, which is a row which is present immediately above that element. So it will be 15 s square plus k equal to 0. So we have auxiliary equation as 15 s square plus k equal to 0. We are going to keep the value of k as k marginal, and it is equated to 0. We have 15 s square plus 750 equal to 0. If you try to solve, you are going to have two roots, plus or minus 7.07j, which is intersection with imaginary axis. Then we have step number 7. So in this case, we don't have complex conjugate either poles or zeros, so this step is not applicable for us. Then we have step number 8. So in this step number 8, we are going to have the plot on graph paper. In step number 8, we are going to draw the final plot on S-plane. From the open loop transfer function, we know that the poles are at 0, it is at minus 5, and it is at minus 10. And the root locus is existing between 0 and minus 5, and from minus 10 up to minus infinity. Correct? We know the centroid is located at minus 5, and from here the asymptotes is going to pass with angle of 60, 180 and 300. So this represents theta 1, which is at 60 degree, this represents theta 2, which is at 180, and this represents theta 3, which is at 300 degrees. Fine. Then we came to know that the breakaway point, which is a valid breakaway point, is at minus 2.11. So that is breakaway point. And we came to know that the k marginal value is 750, and it is going to have the intersection with imaginary axis at plus or minus 7.07j. Fine. So we are going to draw a root locus which is going to pass through this breakaway point, and it is going to have intersection with imaginary axis at plus or minus 7.07j. So from here the root locus is going to start, and it is going to cut this imaginary axis at 7.07j. similarly, it is going to pass through this breakaway point and have intersection with imaginary axis at minus 7.07j. So if you see P minus Z, so from that we know three branches are approaching infinity. So this is the first branch which is approaching infinity, this is the second branch which is approaching infinity, and this is the third branch which is approaching infinity. Step number 9, we are going to comment on stability. The k marginal value is 750, that represents the system is marginally stable. When k value is less than 750 and greater than 0, so we say that the system is stable. K value is greater than 750, then we say that the system is unstable. These are my references. Thank you.